everybody. Welcome to Coffee and Conversations with the one and only J-Man. Your morning will never be the same. Here we go.
I've been sad, I've been lost, I've been down and I've been lonely. I've been suffering at a job in a world that tries to own me. But when I wake up every morning, there's an image of a better place. Yeah. Cause the harder that we grind, then the sweeter is the glory. People say I'm foolish. People say I'm blinded by faith. But if I run out of air, if I crash, I don't care. I'm gonna do it my way. I can make it through this. You can throw the world in my face. But the fear gives me life, and I swear till I die, I'm gonna do it my way. Put me down, criticize me with your lies and with your parody. Yeah. In the darkness, I don't hide, cause I got pride that gives me clarity. I still wake up in the morning with the vision of a better life. See, the option of defeat's just not written in my story. People say I'm foolish. People say I'm blinded by faith. But if I run out of air, if I crash, I don't care. I'm gonna do it my way. I can make it through this. You can throw the world in my face. But the fear gives me life, and I swear till I die, I'm gonna do it my way. I don't care, I'm gonna do it my way. I can make it through this. You can throw the world in my face. But the fear gives me life, and I swear till I die, I'm gonna do it my way. Let me fly through the air. If I crash, I don't care, I'm gonna do it my way. Cause the fear gives me life, and I swear till I die, I'm gonna do it my way.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. I hope you all are having a great, great, great weekend. You're listening to Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Mad on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do. I hope you all are having a great weekend. I hope you all are having a great week, looking forward to the weekend. It is going to be a great show. I have something that I want you all to listen to. I hope you all really enjoy this and soak this in. Be good. Be great. I'll be back after this happens.
It has been said about people that when people know better, they do better. And that sounds really, really profound. But over the years of my life, I wonder, is it true? Because everything that sounds good isn't always true. When people know better, they do better. I can't even say that's always true in my own life. Because there's a difference between knowing better and doing better. I know I don't have no business with dessert. I said I was gonna watch my carbs. I know I should get up every morning early and exercise about 5:30 and jog about 3 miles. I know better. I know what to eat and what not to eat. I know what is healthy, what is not healthy. I have been informed. I have been educated. I know not to eat those oxtail. I know. Uh-oh, y'all not gonna talk to me this morning. I know I don't need those barbecue ribs and the french fries. The waitress even asks you, do you want salad? And I sometimes just say, no. I know not to let them bring bread to the table, because I know if it gets to the table, it's gonna, you know, especially if it's hot and it's warm and they've got good bread. I know not to even risk bringing it that close to me, because I know I'm not strong enough to resist it. When people know better, they say they do better, but it is possible. I know how to do curls. I know how to bench press. I know how to do lat pull down. I know how to do it. I know the form. I know what I ought to be doing. I know I should stretch every morning. It is not the absence of knowledge that always deters the activity, but the gulf between what we know and what we do is often a wide gulf, and we don't always reach across. While it is impossible to do better if you don't know better, it's impossible. You can't do better if you don't know better. Often we still know better than we do. The truth of the matter is, doing better isn't always easy. Sometimes it's real tough. Doing better isn't always easy. We know what we should be doing, but we don't always do it. Sometimes we don't do better until we get in trouble. Sometimes we don't do better until we're under threat. Sometimes we don't do better until we have competition. Doing better on the job. We know what to do. We used to do it when we first got the job and we didn't take it for granted. We knew not to take a 2.5 hour lunch. We knew how to be in our place. We knew not to be on the phone and playing video games in our office. We knew better. But whether we know better and what we do is two different things altogether. Especially when you realize that the people we admire the most were people who put into action what they knew, who grew and changed and made corrections. They became our heroes because they had the courage to change course. All of the people that we highlight in our country and our history are people who had the courage to change course. Leaders like Abraham Lincoln had the courage to change course. It is not now, we always honor people after they're dead. But in real time speed, our heroes were not popular because they went against the course and they swam upstream against the grain, and they had to have courage to change the course. That's not easily done. Dr. King had to have courage to change the course. Nelson Mandela went to jail to change the course. You can get in trouble to change the course. Corrections can often have severe consequences. Corrections can often have severe consequences. Getting it right can have severe consequences. Because see, you make a decision at one stage in your life, and then later you know better, but you're already in the situation. A young man said something to me I will never forget. He said, I am the world's best at getting into situations and the world's worst at getting out. And I think the reason it becomes so difficult to get out is because sometimes it's become so complicated. It requires humility that some people lack the ability to quiet their ego enough to achieve the ability of change, because sometimes you have to go against what you said at this stage to correct where you are at that stage. And so until you become strong enough to admit, yes, I said it, but I was wrong, you can't bring about change. And sometimes your ego will make you be loyal to a mistake. I'm wondering if there's anybody in here who's ever been loyal to a mistake, and you, it was a mistake, and you knew it was a mistake, but you counted up the cost to fix it, and you decided you would just take the easy way out and live with it. Our decisions, you see, to correct our mistakes can create disruption, and not only disruption for us, disruption for other people. And when you look at what it's going to take to straighten it out, sometimes you just don't do it. And when you don't do it, you become trapped in a nightmare of regret. You'd be surprised how long you can live in the prison of your problems. You'd be surprised how long you can live a life where you clap like you're free, you talk like you're free, you move like you're free, but you're really not free at all, because you are trapped in a complicated situation. You can't get out and you can't get in. You're just stuck. And until you correct your past decisions, you are not going to get the breakthrough that you need. And still, until you stop using shopping for therapy, you're never going to have the credit rating that you should have. No matter how much he's Jehovah Jireh, he can't be Jehovah Jireh to you, because as fast as he pours it in, you leak it out. And you know what it takes to fix it, and you know the discipline that's required to get your life together, but it's not always true that people who know better do better. And not doing better simply leaves you stuck. People often lack the stomach for it, I think, to risk the pain of changing course, the uncertainty of what would life be like outside of the bubble of my normal. I hate my normal, but I'm afraid of change. So I'd rather stick with the devil I know. Have you ever grown up and rethought your choices? Have you ever got more information and rethought your choices? Have you ever looked back at your life in retrospect and found yourself in situations that were based on bad information, immature decisions, selfishness, emotionalism, pride, discontentment, and restlessness, and now you're more mature and you're wiser, and you wonder what you could have been had you started earlier on the right road, and you lay down at night and live with the frustration, wonder what would have happened had I not got myself stuck? We're almost like the woman in the commercial, "Help, I've fallen and I can't get up. I changed churches and I can't get up. I changed spouses and I can't get up. I changed jobs and I can't get up. I changed my major and I can't get up. I changed my hairstyle and I can't get up. I changed the way I dress and I can't get up. It doesn't matter what I got on. It doesn't matter what I look like. I cannot seem to get up." So you give up when you can't get up. And you decide to yourself, "Maybe I just have to make the best of a bad situation." I guess I'm really talking about making a decision to live with regret. And you'd be surprised how many people in this room are living with regret. that they could clean up, that they could fix it, they could change it, they could alter. But sometimes the dilemma is it easier to live with regret or live without it and cause the disruption that is necessary in my normal to see the growth that I long to see in my life? Are you hearing what I'm saying about? Either way you go, have you ever been in a situation where either decision you made is gonna cause pain? Have you ever been weighing the pain? You know, when I got ready to have back surgery, I wouldn't have had back surgery if I wasn't in pain. But I had to weigh the pain that I had before the surgery against the pain of having the surgery. And it took me a long time to make up my mind to have the surgery, because either way I went, it was going to be pain. And I had to decide, I ultimately decided that I would rather live with the pain of recovery rather than to live with the pain of ambivalence and indifference and the pain of ignoring and the pain of looking the other way and the pain. I never will forget, I was in Washington, D.C., and I was in the hotel room, and I was walking across the hotel room and fell and hit a glass coffee table and shattered the table. And I said, that's it. I gotta do something about this. This is unbearable. I had been laying on the floor in the back before I went out to speak each night at the New Year's revival because my back was in such pain that I couldn't hardly take it. One time I sat down in the service and I couldn't get up, and my security had to come get me up out of the seat, and I was in front of people, and little by little by little by little, I thought, this pain is too much. The pain of ignoring it, the pain of looking the other way, the pain of making the best out of a bad situation, the pain of not wanting to make any way, the pain of dealing with my inability to walk into the unfamiliar, to walk into the unknown. I had never had surgery. I couldn't imagine what it would be like. It didn't sound good when they described it to me. They said, we're going to cut into your back 4 inches. I thought, not mine, you're not. You're not going to cut me up like you're slicing ribs at a barbecue. In fact, you have to have the adaptability in life to be able to change course. It's not like you get it right and it stays the way you left it. Life keeps changing. And as life keeps changing and seasons keeps changing and circumstances keep changing, you got to be flexible enough to change on a dime and switch this way and turn back this way. And if you don't make the right switch at the right time, you find yourself stuck. And you wake up one morning and you realize, I'm getting older and I don't know what it feels like to have lived my best life. I've not lived my best life. I've not lived at the top of what my potential was. I've not reached the zenith of possibilities of what I could be. I've not fulfilled my purpose. I've not finished my course. I don't get any crown for me because I wasn't living my best life. I was surviving my old life. You don't have to live in this chaos. Your spirit has been in a state of constant disruption because you won't change course. And I don't want you to live in this constant, chaotic, stressful environment of forlornment, because your mistakes and your miracles are cohabitating in the same space. All I need from you is the courage to change course. If you don't change course, you're gonna mess up your destiny. If you don't change course, you're gonna mess up your future. If you don't change course, you're not going to be in the place you need to be to become who I created you to be. If you don't change course, you're going to spend the latter years miserable because you won't own up to your mistakes and acknowledge that you were wrong and you won't fix it. You know what they say? The definition of lunacy is to continue to do the same thing, expecting a different result. You can't be the woman you want to be and the woman you used to be at the same time. You cannot be the man you were created to be and the man you used to be at the same time. And you know that now. But the problem is, you just can't bring yourself to change course because of all the people that it would hurt for you to change. And how long will you make those people more important than your destiny? You've been in bondage. You can't even be your best self. You can't do your best work. You can't be who you were created to be because you're stuck in a situation that you helped to create, and you're guilty. And you feel guilty, and you overcompensate because you're guilty, and you're in this situation because you're guilty, and you're stuck because you're, either way you move, somebody's going to get hurt, and if you don't move, it's going to be you. That means I might not get to say everything I want to say. That means I got to hold my peace sometimes. That means sometimes I got to bite my lip. That means sometimes I've got to learn another discipline. That means sometimes I got to bleed. But if I have to bleed to be better, I'm willing to bleed. I'm willing to bleed a little while to be better for a long time. See, I realized that if I didn't have the surgery, the pain would never go away. And if I had the surgery, I would have pain for a little while, but eventually the pain of recovery will go away. See, circumcision hurts real bad, but it doesn't hurt real long. Putting out the bond woman hurt real bad, but it didn't hurt real long. And you gotta decide, are you willing to have a little momentary discomfort to be where you are called to be? Or are you so concerned about the disruption that your change creates that you're willing to be a prisoner in your own life the rest of your life? Because every time I ever made a change, somebody got hurt. When God called me to come to Dallas, somebody got hurt in West Virginia. There are people who don't like me now. I've been here 25 years and they're still mad. There are other people that accept it and they're glad about it. They see it, they get it. But there are some people that just simply refuse to get over. And I had to decide, am I going to spend the rest of my life honoring your expectations of me? Break your chain today. The chain that ties you to living up to other people's expectations all of your life. The chain that circumvents you from reaching your destiny and your purpose so you can go ahead and fulfill what God created you to fulfill.
I hope that you all really enjoyed that and got something out of that. It was an amazing conversation to hear, and I know it helped me dealing with a lot of adjustments when change is inevitable, whatever the word is, when change is purpose to happen. We have to understand that change is going to hurt somebody. Growing, doing better, being better. It takes change to make that happen. So I hope you all enjoyed that and that it has helped you today. You all have a great, 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 great weekend, and I'll see you all next week. Be good, be great.
is simple. I love it. Having you near me, having you here. Our conversations outrageous. You smile and I smile and I say, ooh, this is getting personal, personal, personal. Let's stay for a while and play. Girl, let's make this a moment. Oh, giving you the best of me. Amazing.
Amazing.
Amazing. Oh, having you close to me. Amazing. Outrageous. Oh. Give your best to me.
Oh.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Here's breakfast. Lost track of time, but we had a ball. Let's catch a movie.
A movie.
Then dinner. Tonight's the night. We'll just unwind and stay. Hey. Let's stay personal, personal, personal. Let's stay for a while and play. Such a beautiful moment. Oh,
giving you the best of me.
Ooh,
amazing.
Somewhat amazing.
Amazing.
Oh,
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 having you close to me.
Having you close to me.
Amazing.
Amazing.